So today I wanted to do a video on like confidence and why I think it's like overrated and what you should work on instead. So I'm out here in nature, one because I've been for a run, but also because I was recording the Choose to Rise series, which if you don't know about, it's basically an audio series I'm working on called Choose to Rise. I won't go on about it too much because if you watch my Instagram stories or my other videos, you'll have heard a lot about this, so I don't want to like keep repeating myself. But basically, I've been recording this audio series. I've never done anything like this before, and I'll be honest, like, I'm not confident about it. Like, not because I don't know it's good, because I think anything like heartfelt and anything that comes from a loving place is always good. So I know it's really good. Like, I know it's really, really good. But yeah, I'm not confident with it. And the reason I'm not confident with it is because I don't know what I'm doing, if I'm honest. Like, I'm totally winging it. I've never done anything like this before. I've never recorded audio. So, like, I don't know if sometimes, like, I'm speaking too fast. Like, if the audio quality's, like, good enough. If it really makes sense. If people will necessarily get it. Because it's very much about, like, self-love and... Well, it is about self-love, and not everybody really truly understands what it is to like love yourself. It's really quite like spiritual, not spiritual in the fact that if you're not spiritual, it won't make sense. It's not like really woo-woo or anything like that. But it is something that not everyone's going to get. Like, I think it's going to be quite Marmite, and I've just had to work with the tools I've got. That's what my intuition is telling me. Like, my intuition was saying, like, don't go and spend loads of money on, like, getting a microphone and all this expensive, like, software to edit it. Like, just work with what you've got. And, like, the perfectionist in me that's really always trying to get out, and I really have to rein that perfectionism in, because I don't think perfectionism is healthy at all. Want it to, like, be the best, like, wants to be the most like articulate, to make sense, for to get everyone to get it, to have the highest possible audio quality. And it's none of those things. And this isn't a thing where like I'm talking myself down or anything. Like, I'm actually really proud of the series. I've never felt so fulfilled, so aligned, so loving. It's just like I really feel like I'm like living in my purpose right now, and it's just the best feeling in the world. And that's why I wanted to do this video, and it's the reason I haven't been doing videos recently, because I've been working really hard on this, is to say you don't always have to be confident. Like, I'm not confident in the series. Like, I'm not gonna like pretend that I'm really confident and I think everyone's gonna love it. I hope they will, but I'm really working on like letting the outcome go, like not needing to control it, not needing it to everybody to love it, or it to sell loads, or, and once over, I would have needed it to sell loads and everyone to love it and to do really well. And I would have needed that because I didn't love myself enough to say, like, you are good enough, Kirsty. Like, this stuff is really good. Like, but now I love myself enough to know that it is really good, because I've been myself. Like, I've given everything I can, I've given my best, and that's like a really loving place. So I want to say, like, confidence is bullshit. There's like been times when I've been really confident to do something, but I haven't necessarily like loved myself, like, in the process. And I think sometimes we think people who are like confident, who get out there and do stuff, really, really love themselves, and it just means like they're confident in that area. It doesn't mean they love themselves. So kind of what I've learned now is like confidence is like bullshit. In fact, like, I had like certain things that I was really, really like quite confident with, and it's just like confidence comes with practice, and that like made me believe that I loved myself. And actually I realized, like, there was many times when I was confident and I really didn't love myself. So I've learnt now that, like, you don't have to be confident. Like, you just have to be courageous and brave. And being courageous quite often means, like, you do something even if you're shitting yourself. Like, this audio series, like, I've kind of been shitting myself about it. Like, because there's been this, like, inner dialogue of kind of saying to me, like, the audio quality is not good enough, or people might not like this, or, you know, like that inner critic. And I've loved myself enough to kind of go, like, I hear you inner critic, like, but I love myself to do this anyway. I love myself to let the outcome go, to not worry if people buy it or they don't buy it, or they love it or they don't love it. And through doing that, like, I've never felt so happy, so fulfilled, to just say, like, fuck it. Like, I used to think that I had to go to all these, like, blogging events and do all this blogging stuff, like, to be successful and to be something. And I realised, like, that was just all masking the fact that, like, I didn't love myself. Like, I felt like I needed all this stuff. And now I'm just like, fuck it. I don't need any of that stuff. Like, I love myself enough to, like, to not care. But I also know, like, the self-love stuff is a ladder. And also I know that I have to keep choosing to rise, which is what the series is about, because I want to get to a place where, like, I'm not having that inner critic in me, like worrying about the audio quality and stuff. So that bit hasn't completely gone, but the point is, like, I'm in a really good self-loving place of kind of going, fuck it, like, I'm worried about these things, but, like, shush, inner critic. Like, I love myself enough that I'm gonna, like, execute. I'm gonna do it anyway. And I feel like sometimes we don't execute because of, like, we're not courageous enough, we're not brave enough, and we'll say it's because we're not confident enough. But actually, you don't need to be confident to execute. It doesn't need to be perfect. Like, done is better than, like, done but it not being perfect is still better than, like, not done. Do you know what I mean? Like, yeah, like, I don't think anything's ever gonna be perfect. So, like, you don't have to be confident in yourself. Like, confidence will come when you just start doing stuff. But be brave, be courageous. Like, go after what you want in life. Like, because joy, fulfillment, like, love, all those things you're chasing, like, feeling successful, whatever, it's all within. Like, I feel really fulfilled at the moment. This series is not even out yet. Like, I feel fulfilled, even though I don't know how it's gonna go. Which goes to, like, prove the point, like, fulfillment and all these things, joy, like, happiness, it's all a internal thing. And I got to being fulfilled by realizing I wasn't fulfilled. Like, there was such a long time of me not realizing that I wasn't fulfilled, and then when I, like, realised I wasn't fulfilled, when I realised I wasn't, like, loving myself, that's when I was able to change it. So, yeah, it's all internal stuff. So, you don't have to be confident. Confidence will come. But go out there, be brave, be courageous, and I'll see you soon. Bye.